Hello, my beautiful friends. Welcome to a new video. Thank you for being here. Today, we're going to talk about the differences between ser and estar. This can be a very challenging topic for Spanish students because in English, you only have to use to be, and now suddenly in Spanish, you have to adapt to two words like what? But it's not as hard as you think once you put it into practice and you know when to use which. Hopefully this video will give you some insight in it. Now let's start with ser. Ser, it's an irregular verb. So prior bombarding you with a bunch of examples, I'm gonna teach you how to conjugate it in the present tense with every person. Yo soy, tú eres, él, ella o usted es, nosotros o nosotras somos, vosotros o vosotras sois. Ellos, ellas, o ustedes son. Okay, so let's get to it. First use. Andrea es bonita. Andrea is pretty. What are we doing here? We are talking about someone's physical appearance. So every time you're trying to describe how someone is, you're going to use ser. This also applies to personality traits. So for example, Andrea es amable. Andrea is kind. Let's see some more examples. Mi mamá es una buena persona. My mom is a good person. Carlos y José son groseros. Carlos and José are rude. Tú eres muy alta. You are very tall. Angélica es inteligente. Angélica is intelligent. Yo soy guapo. I am handsome. Please note that the personal pronouns like yo, tú, are between brackets because they're not really necessary for our sentence to make sense in Spanish. Second use, Andrés es mi novio. Andrés is my boyfriend. What are we doing here? We are talking about how this person has a relationship with me. So our second use for ser would be to talk about our personal relationships. For example, Alex es mi hermana. Alex is my sister. Karen y Mariana son mis amigas. Karen and Mariana are my friends. Vosotros sois mis profesores. You are my teachers. Third use. Yo soy colombiana. I am Colombian. We also use ser to talk about nationality. For example, James es inglés. James is English. Karina y Camila son peruanas. Karina and Camila are Peruvian. And religion. Juana es católica. Juana is a Catholic. Farid es musulmán. Farid is a Muslim. Fourth use. Mañana es viernes. Tomorrow is Friday. Son las 6 de la tarde. It's 6 p.m. So we also use ser to talk about time. Other examples are, hoy es 21 de abril. Today is April the 21st. Son las 5 de la mañana. It's 5 in the morning. Fifth use. So I previously said that we use ser to talk about nationalities, but we actually use it to talk about origin in general. For example, to talk about the material something is made of, or to talk about where an object is coming from. For example, este vino es de Chile. This wine is from Chile. Mis aretes son de plata. My earrings are made of silver. La pared es de concreto. The wall is made of concrete. Esta piedra es de Bolivia. This stone is from Bolivia. Sixth use, soy psicóloga. I am a psychologist. We also use ser when we are talking about professions. Other examples are, Andrea es ingeniera. Andrea is an engineer. Juan es mecánico. Juan is a mechanic. Iván es futbolista. Iván is a soccer player. The ultimate tip for you to learn the difference between ser and estar is, if you're talking about something permanent, lasting, something that does not change, you're probably gonna use ser. And if you're talking about something temporary, something that changes, you're going to use estar. Now let's see the uses of estar for you to see what I'm talking about. But first, how to conjugate them. Yo estoy. Tú estás. Él, ella o usted está. Nosotros o nosotras estamos. Vosotros o vosotras estáis. Ellos, ellas o ustedes están. Remember that this conjugation is for the present tense. Estoy feliz. I start with this example because this one is a pretty good one to establish the difference between ser and estar. Emotions are a temporary state. So if I'm trying to express that I am happy right now at the moment, then I will say estoy feliz. If I want to say that I am a happy person in general, despite whatever situation is going on in my life, then I would say soy feliz. ¿Estás feliz o eres feliz? Let's see some more examples with emotions. Carolina está enojada. Carolina is pissed. Mis hermanos están tristes. My siblings are sad. Vosotros estáis cansados. You are tired. Jennifer está enferma. Jennifer is sick. And I do this example because I want to show you that it also applies with state of health. Second use. Estoy soltera. I am single. When talking about your marital status or someone else's, you're also going to use estar. María y Daniel están casados. María and Daniel are married. Ross está divorciado. Ross is divorced. Jessica está comprometida. Jessica is engaged. There is an exception though. If you're talking about being a widow, then you would use ser. For example, soy viuda o él es viudo. Third use. El baño está al lado de esta habitación. The bathroom is next to this bedroom. Las llaves están en la mesa. The keys are at the table. Estoy en el cine. I am at the movies. So we also use estar when talking about locations. Here are more examples. ¿Dónde estás? That means where are you? Thought I'd drop that useful question right here. Estoy en el supermercado. I am at the supermarket. Laura y Ángela están en el baño. Laura and Ángela are in the bathroom. Estamos en el concierto. We are at the concert. ¿Estás en clase? Are you in class? Fourth use. Estoy lavando la ropa. I'm doing laundry. Estamos pintando la casa. We're painting the house. You guessed it right. We also use estar when we are talking about actions. More examples. Estoy jugando tenis. I am playing tennis. Daniel está trabajando. Daniel is working. Juan está leyendo. Juan is reading. Fifth use. Estoy acostada. I am laying down. Estamos sentados. We're sitting down. Tú estás de pie. You are standing. Use estar when talking about physical position. And that was it for today's video. Thank you so much for watching. If you have any questions or suggestions, you can leave them in the comments. If you like this video, do not forget to smash that thumbs up button, subscribe to our channel, and turn on notifications so you don't miss the videos we're gonna be posting. It's a pleasure to learn Spanish with you. Hasta la próxima.